Behind that red door lies my studio. I have been in this studio for the better part of 2013 to 19 years, somewhere between 15 and 16 years. Every single square inch of every wall and floor and ceiling of this studio tells a story.
Not even looking.
Well, these don't tell a story. These dominoes, for example. Remember that video I made a few years ago about the hours in my day? I made them with these. Everywhere in this space is a story. Every single one of these pictures and posters and drawings and everything on the wall, it's a prop from one of my movies. Those were the original poster ideas for my HBO show from 2010. So why am I bringing this up now? Well, I've been in New York City for 18 years. And the truth is, my days here are numbered. I've been talking about it forever, but the family, we're inching closer to leaving the city once and for all. And as I think about that, I'm struggling to figure out how to say goodbye to this space without having to say goodbye to all of the stories and all of the history in this space. What kind of a psychopath has camera battery chargers like that? There's a story there. See this wall? It used to look like this. And this part of the studio used to look like this. And this? So I had this idea, I came up with this idea. I think it's a great idea. Here goes. Why don't I make a book about this studio? And when I say book, I don't mean a book like this. I don't mean a book that's, you know, words. I mean a book like this. This is one of my favorites. A book that's mostly pictures. Honestly, why do I even have this Justin Bieber book? A book that's mostly pictures. And along with the pictures are little tiny stories that give context to the photos. Picture like a hardcover, like a coffee table book, about the history, like the 13-year history of my studio. Because I have all the documentation and photos that go all the way back that tell the whole history of this space. And it wouldn't just be a story of the physical space, but of the people too. Like way back, like we used to have these contests where we'd see how far we could swing, and jump off of those rings. We dismantled it because we didn't want to get sued, but I used to have a half pipe in here. Oh. Also used to have like this heavy knotted rope that we tied to the ceiling and... So I'm not 100% on how to get a book made, so I called I called my agent and I said I want to make this book, and he said, we have to go to publishers and pitch the idea. That sounds horrible. Told him I'm not comfortable with that. He said, put together a video of the idea and we can use that. That kind of made sense, but you know, if I'm gonna make a video, I gotta put it on YouTube. This video is meant to be a pitch video for book publishers. You get what I'm saying with the idea though, right? Like a fancy like $30 hardcover book that you like, somebody buys for you as a gift, or you buy for somebody as a gift, and it's like a, not like a sit down in a novel, but like a wow, like and make a great book, right? Can see the potential of my coffee table book idea. If you're a book publisher and you think that this is a good idea, call Ben Davis at WME and tell him, hey Ben, we would like to make Casey's coffee table book. All right, thanks a lot. This is snow. This is snow because it's freezing. Freezing cold out in New York City. I'm gonna do a throwback. Back to warmer, better times.
production here. That's all us. I think we're gonna be doing that next. First shot. The first shot is an homage to my vlog, so it's gonna be a time lapse. But then Kevin is on the phone. Is he gonna step in? Can I reveal all this, or is it too much of a giveaway?
That's fine. It's all good.
Who is he swearing?
I'm shooting 2 episodes a day for my fucking show. 2 episodes. You know what you're doing? Fucking about to order some goddamn wheat pancakes, bro. Get off my phone.
So last August, I was in Los Angeles to shoot an episode of Kevin Hart's like fitness YouTube show called What the Fit.
Yeah! What up, world? Kevin Hart here, shooting my show, What the Fit. Now, what is What the Fit? I'll tell you what the fit is. What the Fit is a show where I include myself and my celebrity friends, and we do a bunch of physical fit activities that they have no idea that we're gonna do. And today, I got my guy, Casey Neistat, with me. Casey, say hey.
Hey.
There you go.
It was an awesome day. I had a lot of fun. It was like, I don't know, it was just cool. It was cool being around Kevin. It was cool being around a big production like that. I shot a vlog about the whole day. And then I came home, and the next morning I get a phone call from the producers, and they were like, hey, totally cool if you want to make a vlog about the shoot, but please don't release it until after the episode comes out. So the episode came out yesterday, and I thought I could maybe lean into this footage a little bit.
Got lifeguard history. Granted, I got fired because I let a kid drown. That's a long story. He didn't die. He did not die.
But Kevin's a comedian. When he said I used to be a lifeguard until I got fired because someone almost drowned, I thought that was a joke, but he just kept saying it, and then he eventually told me the story, and it's totally true. Nobody died, but when he was on like patrol, he was like a teenager, someone actually like badness happened, one of the other lifeguards rescued that person, and he was literally fired from being a lifeguard. That was the truth. Appreciate the story, glad nobody got hurt. Getting changed, putting on my lifeguard gear. Hey, what about my microphone?
So once you put that on, we'll reset you. I'm gonna redo everything when I get you. Thank you, buddy.
Okay.
You can go ahead and set up and I'll grab you shortly.
I'm good.
All right, Casey, here we go on three. 1, 2, 3.
Okay. You got it, Casey.
Don't forget to wrap that can around your shoulder.
Wrap the can! No, he's gonna trip. He didn't pay attention.
Look at that.
He didn't pay attention.
Okay, what you don't see in that moment when I jumped in the water is that I lost my hat and I found my hat, but I also lost my glasses. And in the next couple of scenes, I don't have on glasses. No glasses.
Can do some beast patrolling.
Oh yeah.
Does this car have like a loudspeaker, like a PA system?
And what had happened was like, they were gone into the ocean, and I was kind of like, ugh, and I just gave up on them. And I remember like one of the producers being like, how are we gonna shoot the rest of the show now you don't have glasses? Not a big deal, just do it without glasses. And then like, you'll notice I'm in the car, and all of a sudden.
So we're en route.
I should have ate.
So while we're shooting that funny scene in the truck, which is like 30 seconds in the video, but we were in that truck for like an hour and a half, one of the lifeguards, pretty sure it was one of the lifeguards, comes running over to the truck and is like, Casey, I found your glasses. And the dude, I guess, swam around in the ocean for a while, and he actually recovered my glasses. Can you see those scratches? That's from when these were swimming in the bottom of the ocean.
Also, if you have strings on your swim trunks, keep them tied at all times. We're gonna start fining.
That's not correct.
So the whole car scene, like we're in the car and then all of a sudden we're at the end of the pier. So in the video, it's like, you know, it's like instant. The reality of that is that we had to drive from the beach up onto the pier, which wasn't that far. But Kevin was screaming on the loudspeaker the entire time. And like, you forget how famous this guy is. And the whole car was mobbed by people.
Great.
Let's go.
Casey, where's my guy?
Go. Let's go.
So we got one.
And there were just crowds, like throngs and throngs of people. And if you look, you can see all the spectators right as Kevin jumps off the end. So it was a super fun day. It was a really fun experience for me. I think the biggest takeaway of that whole day for me was when I watched this episode back, so it's 15 minutes for the What the Fit episode, it really kind of feels like a seamless, like quick, easy piece of cake shoot. When in reality, like the behind the scenes of this, there was a crew of well over 100 people on that, like major cameramen everywhere, still photographers. Look at this camera cluster here. I forget, because I spend so much time on YouTube, I forget what goes into like an actual real production like that. All right, check it out. I'm gonna link that below. Kevin and What the Fit crew, thank you for having me. Check it out.
That lady got her breasts out on the beach. You better cover your breasts up.
That's a guy. Yeah, see the.
You're right.
Yeah,
absolutely right.
Captain Smith from the lifeguard squad. His son gave me this hat. Thank you very much, guys. It was a pleasure working with you.